We are going to Be'ezrat Hashem to start new halachot. We are not skipping in between the Siman Kuf Chavtet that we did last time, and also Kuf Lamed we did. We spoke it out as we were learning the Siman Kuf Chavchet. So now we're going to Be'ezrat Hashem to do Kuf Lamed Aleph. We're going to speak about the concept of Nefilat Apayim. Nefilat Apayim means the following. The Gemara in Masechet Megillah brings down the concept of people saying Tahanunim, asking Hashem for forgiveness. Now, a lot of us, Baruch Hashem, are able to afford to ask Hashem to forgive us. We have a lot to give away. I mean, the bad deeds, the good deeds we want to keep, we want to hold on tight. It's the things that are not so good that we want to give away. And we say to Hashem, Avar Hatanu, Pashanu, Avinu, Anachnu, Avotenu. This is the main part of the Tachanunim. People are supposed to know that. I want to point out, when you say Anna, please. When you say Anna, there is one of the most important parts where you're supposed to say Tachanun is as follows. The key words are as follows. You say Anna Hashem Elokeinu Elokei Avotenu Tavo Lefanecha Tefilatenu. Let our prayer come before you. And please, don't look away. We're not Azei Panim Kesheolev. We're not those stubborn people who want to say Hashem, we are tzaddikim, we never sinned. This is the key point of the Hanun. Aval chatanu avinu pashanu anachnu vavotenu v'anshei betel. People are supposed to know what that means. When you say the Hanunim, they say Shulchan Aruch brings down all the way in the beginning. When you're asking Hashem for forgiveness, or in general when you're praying, he says tov me'at bekavana me'avot b'lo kavana. He says it's better to say a little bit and understand and mean what you're saying than saying a lot and not knowing what you mean and what you're saying. Which means it's a great deal. It does not take a long time. It's a pen and pencil. You take a sidur and you translate one word at a time. I promise you, if you do one word a day, one day you'll finish the whole tefillah. If you do one word a day, but if you do five words a day, you'll finish in no time, faster. It does not take a long time. A lot of people, for some reason, do not take the great deal of studying what tefillah is all about. The Gemara in Masechet Megillah brings down that in Yerushalayim, it says when Nebuchadnezzar came and he destroyed everything that was on the way. It says he destroyed all the big houses. He says he destroyed the palaces, the Beit HaMikdash, and he says in every big house that was in Yerushalayim, the Gemara says over there, question, what do you mean? If I tell you I destroyed all the palaces and all the nice houses of Yerushalayim, obviously every big house had to go in the process. Obviously it would happen. The Gemara says, no, what it means is as follows. There is a house and there is a house. A house which you live in, it's a regular house. But there are other houses where we say it's a home away from home. Where the Gemara is a dispute between Rabbi Yoshua ben Levi and Rabbi Yochanan, I believe. Each one said a different pshat. One said, Bayit Gadol means a big house. Does not mean literally big. The word Gadol means also Ligdol. Ligdol means to grow. He says there were houses where they actually grew in understanding what tefillah is. And there were houses where they also grew in understanding what Torah is. It's Bay Shemigadlim Bo Torah, Bay Shemigadlim Bo Tefillah. A house, each one has its importance. It's very important to put your effort into Tefillah and into Torah. People that will only understand it. Manai Masechet Shabbat brings down the story. It says over there was a Chacham who was praying and he was taking a great deal of time in praying Shmona Esrei. Praying for a long time. And one rabbi looked at him, he says, Meniach chaye olam ve'osek b'chaye sha. Tefillah is for this world. When you pray, you're praying for the well-being, your well-being, well-being of Klal Yisrael, well-being of all the Jews. You're praying for the good of the world. It all has to do with this world. Torah has something to do with the upper world. So the rabbi looked at him and he said, what is this guy doing playing so long? He's Oseg Bechayesha. He's dealing with something which is in Dunyo. This would be Dunyo Glashtamero. Everything passes by. This world is fast. What you're supposed to be really putting a big, great deal of time is into Torah, into learning, because that's going to be something which is going to give you Nitzchiyut. It's going to give you eternity. Olam Haba, which is forever. So the Maharas is over there and say, listen, there is time to play and there is time to learn. That's what was in the end, the answer. Of course, obviously, learning Torah is more important. Much more important. Torah kuyasta. Every smart person, every foolish person knows that learning Torah is the greatest thing ever. Tefillah, to pray, is very important too. You have to put your great, it's important to put your time and effort into it. So the most important part of Tachanun is to say to Hashem in Balach, Aval, he says, the truth is, Chatanu, we sin, Avinu, we did another type of sin, and Pashanu, we did something, things are on purpose. Anachnu, Otenu, Hashem, Betenu, we, our fathers, our households, please Hashem, forgive us. They say, start saying, Ashamnu, Bagadnu, Gazanu, Dibal, Dopi, and on and on. Another important part of Tachanun is the Veyavot. Vayavor Hashem al panav ikra Hashem Hashem kerachum bechanun. It's very important part of the Tachanun. That is like the key of the Tachanun. The first thing was that. The second thing is this, because when you say the 13 midot, as the famous midrash, the Gemara says Moshe Rabbeinu, when he went up to the up high and he saw Hashem, he told him, Moshe, if you want to ever achieve something before me and you want to get forgiveness, do what I do. What did he say? It says. It says, you'll see my back. And it says over there, what did Moshe Rabbeinu saw over there? Moshe Rabbeinu, what he saw was Moshe Rabbeinu saw HaKadosh Baruch Hu, as if to say, Kivyachol, there's no physical by Hashem, there's no vision, there's nothing there. Hashem is something which we'll never understand what God is until we get to Olam Haba. And Gan Eden, Olam Haba, he says, as if Kivyachol, HaKadosh Baruch Hu dressed up like a Shaliach Tzibur. He put Talit on his head. So he wrapped himself up in the talit, and he was saying, "Yud Gimel Midot." He told him to say the following: If you say Kel Rachum Bechanun, Hashem Hashem Kel Rachum Bechanun, Eder Chafayim, Rav Chesed Abed, Otz Chesed Avim, Otz Chesed Avim, Chatav Enake, these 13 attributes of Hashem's mercy, he says that is the way to attain forgiveness, and this is something very important. People should spend time understanding what these 13 attributes are all about. No need to tell you that there's a famous sefer of the Rabbi Moshe Cordovello, Rabbi Moshe Ramak, he was the student of the Arizal, or the Rebbe of the Arizal. I'm losing track every time. But whichever way you go, he wrote a great sefer on Kabbalah. And it was simple, a sefer, something for us to understand. He was a baby Mikubal. He wrote a sefer called Tomer Devorah. Tomer Devorah is a very important sefer. If you're able to obtain it in any language, Russian, English, Chinese, Japanese, whatever you could, it's a sefer to put your time into it. A person should study the sefer inside out. Every day do a little, because over there they go one by one explaining to you what every single midah is. What is ker, what is rachum, what is chanun, what is elech, what is apayim, what is rav chesed, what's emet. One by one, yakta yakta famod abetia. He explains it thoroughly. And if you learn the sefer of the Tomer Devorah, he explains everything. It's a phenomenal sefer. People should take a great deal of time studying this book. Go through it. I'm sure that they have translated it to Russian already by now. They have it in English. There are many commentaries called Tomer Devorah. Many people out there have translated the book. It's important for people to know what every single midah is. Another part of Tachanun, which is very important also, and people for some reason take it very lightly. There is a, what's it? Put it here, I'll take care of it. Okay, we'll fight afterwards. Okay, so the calculation is like this. Le David Hashem, right? People don't know that this Perek in Tehillim that we say, Zohar explains everything in detail. He says, if you look in the Halakha, Shulchan Aruch brings it down, he says a person is not allowed to talk between Shmona Esre, Chazarat Hashas, repetition of the Shaliach Tzibu, and during Shliach Tzibul, Chazad Hashem Tzibul, you're never allowed to utter a word. You're supposed to be looking into your Sidur and follow every word the Chazan is saying. And you have to be clear about it, looking inside, listening to what Chazad Hashem says, no talking. The famous story with the Rambam, when the Rambam came to Cairo, Egypt, when he came to Cairo, he came there, what do you think the first thing he did? He saw the people over there praying in shuls. They were mezalzel in tefillah. When the Chazan used to do Chazarat Hashat, repetition of Shmona Esre, it became a coffee shop. People started talking. People started getting out of control. You know what the Rambam said? He said, no Chazarat Hashat. You're going to come to Shul, you're going to pray your Shmona Esre. Once you say, Oseh Shalom Bimgomar, finish Asher Yoshev Etecha Uva Letzion, Aleinu Shabeach, and go home. If you don't know the importance of Chazarat Hashat, it's a Chilul Hashem. go to the Arabs, go to the Muslims, La'abdil, over there. Quiet, silent. We as Jews, Baruch Hashem, by them there's no Yetzirah, that's why it's very quiet in their shuls. Besides the fact if they talk, the Imam is going to chop their head off. That's a different story. But by us Jews, we have the Yetzirah, he works. He knows that Tefillah is something very important. And because Tefillah is something very important, automatically, he fights every way possible just to take away from us. As the Gemara says over there, that Tefillah is something which Dvarim Shomnim Berumo Shel Olam. Tefillah is something which is up high. People do they underestimate what Tefillah is. Bnei Adam is Zalzirim, people are belittling every, they don't value Tefillah. Had they known what Tefillah can do for them, not what they could do to Tefillah, what Tefillah will do for them, they would come to shul 5 minutes earlier, 10 minutes early, and start praying to Hashem and devoting themselves, meditating and attaching themselves to Hashem. That is what people will do. That's what people are supposed to be doing. That's not Hashem, we're going to get there. But David Hashem, this is a part of Tehillim. They say as if, to explain, when we pray Shmona Esra, it's pretty much a korban. We are about to say, Hashem, take me. I want to be the korban. I want to dedicate myself to you. Take my life. And as if to say, the Zohar explains, to the extent, he says that it's as if the soul, life, the body and soul, as if are disconnected from one another. They detach. So which means we're going through a time where we are, as if, la'avdil, dead. And in order to bring our souls, reconnect the soul back together with the body, we have to say this perek in Tehillim, David, Alech Hashem, Nafshi Esa, and etc. And if you look, it's very strict over here. People don't know. Do you know that during this perek in Tehillim, you're not allowed to talk? Do you know that during this perek in Tehillim, you're only allowed to answer Chatzi Kaddish and not more? Do you know that you're not allowed to answer on Al Israel, on Yehi Shlama Rava, and Titkabal? You don't answer these three last parts. You only Chatzi Kaddish, like Shema Israel. Chatzi Kaddish only. Very strict laws. And you're supposed to say the Tehillim inside, word by word, everything. Till the end, till you get to Avinu, up until Hashem Elokei says, Shum Mechon Apecha Minachem Al Alamecha, up until there, it's only Chatzi Kaddish, only half. It's very strict. A lot of people don't understand why. Because had they known the importance of Tahanun, they would say it the right way. There's more to it. Bezat Hashem will give more details next time, Bezat Hashem. Wonderful.